Good afternoon, and thank you for joining us for today's Illinois Tollway Building for Success webinar series. If you have joined us previously, welcome back. If this is your first time tuning into our weekly series, we're glad you set aside time in your busy schedule to spend it with us today. I'd like to go over some housekeeping items before we begin today's presentation. First, everyone will be muted. If you would like to submit a question, please use the chat function and include your name and company affiliation so we know who you are. If you are joining us by phone or via computer or laptop, the presentation will be recorded and posted on the Tollway's website afterwards. And finally, please take a few moments to fill out the brief survey following the presentation. We appreciate your feedback and would love to hear how you learned about today's events and if you have suggestions for future topics. The Department of Diversity and Strategic Development is a driving force for increasing economic opportunities in the diverse communities we serve. Through our various programs and initiatives, the Tollway takes an active role in providing access to economic opportunities for small, diverse, and veteran businesses and individuals in the heavy highway construction industry. Today, my department is heavily focused on increased training and educational opportunities like today's webinar, working with internal departments to identify economic opportunities for diverse firms, recruiting new entrants, and supporting programs and initiatives for historically underserved individuals. Today's webinar series topic is Rolling Owner-Controlled Insurance Program. Today's presenter is Paula Blonski, Tollway Senior Manager of Insurance Risk and Loss Control. I'll turn it over to Paula now.
Thank you, Siobhan. Today we're here to present details about the Illinois Tollway's Rolling Owner-Controlled Insurance Program, or ROSIP. In evaluating the barriers for small businesses, the Illinois Tollway's requirement for $25 million in general liability insurance for mainline work was identified as a significant barrier towards participation. The Illinois Tollway's Rolling Owner-Controlled Insurance Program, or ROSIP, addresses this challenge head-on. The ROSIP focuses on creating a level playing field for small businesses while also removing the barrier of access to general liability insurance at levels required by the Tollway. Risk management by the Tollway is not diminished by this program. Rather, it is maintained at its current levels, while the Tollway's scale and stability allow it to purchase insurance at a lower rate than small businesses could do on their own. The ROSIP will be applied to specific project solicitations with a variety of types of work that best match the pool of registered small businesses with the state. These types of work are the most common projects in our ongoing unbundling initiative. Next slide. The ROSIP aligns with current Tollway small business programs while being flexible enough to be used for emerging and future programs. Through the ROSIP, eligible enrolled contractors and subcontractors are provided general liability coverage for on-site operations. Next slide. Next, I would like to talk about the types of insurance included in this program. The ROSIP will provide general liability coverage only for on-site operations, as this was the barrier that we have been told by small firms looking to compete for tollway contracts. Our current mainline construction contracts require $25 million in general liability limits, usually achieved with a first or primary layer of coverage, and then utilizing excess layers of coverage to meet the required limit. This program will also have a similar structure of a lead layer of $2 million and then utilizing excess layers, bringing the coverage up to the $25 million in limits. Again, this coverage is for general liability only for on-site operations. Contractors will still be required to maintain the other coverages we require in our contracts, such as workers' compensation, auto liability, contractors' pollution liability for on-site and off-site exposures, as well as general liability for off-site exposures only. Next slide. Enrollment in the ROSIP will be mandatory for those that bid on contracts in the ROSIP program. Contract documents for contracts in this program will contain a revised insurance specification providing details of the program, as well as a ROSIP manual that outlines the coverage and overall program. The $25 million in coverage will be on a per project basis. In the event of a general liability claim on site under this program, the contractor and or subcontractor on this contract will be responsible for the deductible associated with any claim. The deductible for contractors on this program varies, and it is based on contract value. Next, I would like to turn it over to Siobhan to talk more about the SBI program and how to participate.
We'll take a quick look of how to register with the state. Once you have visited the Illinois Procurement Gateway, IPG website at ipgvendorreg.com, you'll be asked to create an account and we'll be asked for business information like your tax ID number, business information, and contact information. From there, you will work with the CPO's office who will review your application and complete your registration. Once you have registered on the IPG, step two is to register with the Tollways SBI. Registration is simple. You visit us at iltollway.diversitysoftware.com to begin the registration process. The reason for the second registration is to confirm enrollment in the state's program and to qualify the work under the Tollways General Liability Insurance Program, or ROSIP. The Tollways SBI registration process can take up to 5 days. The Tollways Enhanced Small Business Initiative provides exclusive construction, prime, and subcontracting opportunities for registered Illinois small businesses. Thus far in 2021, we have received nearly 7 bids on construction contracts, such as the plaza improvements, landscaping, access road construction, and fencing installation. We have also seen 6 new firms that never submitted a bid as a prime on tollway work actually do so, which speaks to the impact the SBI program is having on the marketplace. We continue to conduct outreach to raise awareness of bid opportunities, work with our technical assistance program providers to lend assistance and expertise to those firms, and make small and diverse businesses aware of other resources available through the diversity department. I will now turn it back over to Paula.
Thank you, Siobhan. So going over the deductible on the ROSIP program, it will be the responsibility of the contractor or subcontractor of a per occurrence deductible. The deductible amounts and responsibilities are outlined in the special provisions as well as the ROSIP manual. In the event of an occurrence, the maximum deductible contribution is calculated as a percentage of the overall contract value, not to exceed $62,500. Next slide. On this slide, you will see how the maximum amount of the deductible will be calculated. For example, for a contract with a contract value of $1 million, the maximum deductible contribution by the contractor or sub would be 0.5% of the $1 million contract value, or $5,000. For a contract of $2 million, the maximum deductible contribution would be $13,000. For a contract of $3 million, the maximum deductible contribution would be $24,000, and so on. Again, the maximum deductible contribution is capped at $62,500, and that's for the larger contracts that are valued over $5 million. Next slide. Next, I would like to talk about and outline how the deductible will be paid in the event of an occurrence. So payment of the contractor deductible shall be deducted from amounts otherwise due the involved contractors or subcontractors. In the event the amounts due to contractor or sub are insufficient to cover the allocated deductible amount, the contractor or its sub shall arrange for direct payment of the allocated amount within 15 days by demand of the owner. If the contractor or sub fails or refuses to pay the allocated amount, The owner may collect the amount by other means authorized by the contract or other means authorized by law. Next slide. When bidding on ROSIP contracts, you must bid the project net of insurance cost. Again, each contractor in each sub shall bid the project net of insurance costs. Contractors shall exclude the cost of any program coverages from its bid and ensure all subs excludes as well. Cost of program coverages is defined as the amount of the contractor and its subs reduction in insurance cost due to eligibility for program coverages, and includes reduction in insurance premiums, related taxes and assessments, markup on the insurance premium, and losses retained through a self-funded, self-insured retention or deductible program. Next, I would like to turn it over to Michael Charles Hilson, who will discuss the role of the ROSIP administrator in this program. Michael.
Paula, thank you. Really appreciate your time today, everybody. My name is Michael Charles Hilson. I am the ROSIP Rolling Owner Controlled Insurance Program Administrator. I first want to thank the Illinois Tollway for the opportunity to allow us to work with them on this phenomenal program, and also thank them for creating an opportunity for the smaller contractors. This program helps the smaller contractors to build capacity from a smaller contract standpoint, where they can build that capacity to work on larger projects with the Illinois Tollway. My job is to help you feel comfortable, to understand that you still have to have your own insurance, that this project specific insurance, when you're enrolled into the program, when I receive your ROSIP enrollment form, either from a prime or the subcontractor, the prime contractors, we need to make sure that you provide us with the notice of subcontractor award form, but when we enroll you in the ROSIP program, you have project-specific insurance for the scope of work for the Illinois Tollway contract. It's our job to help you to feel assured that any questions that you might have in reference to the program, the insurance itself, that we help to make that process as simple as possible. And we're here to answer and address any questions amongst the contractors. So we're here to be that liaison and person that you need to help ease you into getting on the job site. So our role is to help make sure all the I's are dotted and the T's are crossed and making sure to get you enrolled into the program.
Thank you, Michael. I think now we're gonna turn it over to Pete in engineering.
Yes, hello, thank you. Good afternoon, everybody. I'm Pete Fernsler. I'm a deputy chief with the engineering department. So you already heard earlier in this presentation from Siobhan that, the tollway's already awarded 20 small business construction contracts already here in 2021. So if you are currently are successful and are working on the tollway as a small business, and many of those small business contracts, the majority of them are also included in our ROSIP program. So welcome. We'd like to continue to encourage you to consider, bidding and working on tollway work. If you're new to the tollway or haven't been a prime and are on the fence, we're hoping these presentations will help give you some confidence that we're here to support you through that endeavor. So already this year, the tollway, as part of that commitment to unbundling and putting small business contracts out there, we've seen landscaping contracts, pavement repair, plaza improvement contracts. What that means is there's some signing, some striping and electrical at our plazas that we're doing. You may have seen some fence work already earlier this year, roadway lighting repairs, CC or closed circuit television camera repair. So we're always looking for opportunities. So that's what you've already seen this year. Let me tell you a little bit about what's coming up here in the near term. So you'll see, we have a way in motion replacement on I-355, which includes some pavement repair and some electrical work associated with the way in motion. This is basically a system the tollway has to weigh trucks while they're driving over our roadway. So we have some replacement work in way in motion coming up. York Road rehabilitation. What this is on the west side of O'Hare Airport is York Road. It's a north-south roadway. It's a arterial roadway, or it's a local road there, in which as part of our Elgin O'Hare Western Access, We are actually doing some pavement repair, asphalt pavement repair on York Road. So if you are in the pavement patching, you know, there's an opportunity for some work in the vicinity of O'Hare Airport. Mile Long Bridge water main construction. What this is actually placing water main down underneath the bridge. It has to do with our fire suppression system that we have on and adjacent to our Mile Long Bridge. So that would give you some of the drainage contractors an opportunity to be the prime on tollway work. Ramp Q detection, what that is some electrical work on our ramps that allows us to monitor how traffic is backing up at traffic signals that are at the end of our ramps, and it gives us that opportunity to control those signals. So this work is primarily electrical related, but there is some pavement work, in pavement work required associated with this ramp cue detection. Sign structures and dynamic message sign improvements. These are dynamic message signs, are those changeable signs you see over our roadway. We're actually replacing one of those under a contract, and we're doing some sign structure construction for a sign structure, as well as we're replacing some of the signs on our system. So that work's coming up. And the last one I'll talk about here is the Western Access pipe management. So at O'Hare Airport, we're building the Elgin O'Hare Western Access, which goes around the west side of O'Hare Airport. We actually had to buy a concrete pipe manufacturing facility. So after we took ownership of that facility, we're actually looking for a contractor to come in and do some some sorting of actually the inventory that's left on site. The hope there is we'll get it sorted out. We'll be able to inventory it and utilize some of that those assets that we purchased as part of purchasing this plant. So those are a couple coming up here. So if I can go to the next slide. So you want to find out what's coming up, on tollway contracts. So if you go up to our website, we have upcoming bid opportunities. We actually have on our website, and I'll show you here at the end of this slide, how to access our bid letting schedule. So we update our bid letting schedule for construction approximately every 1 to 2 weeks. We try to give contractors who are thinking about the tollway a 6 months look ahead, to get a feel for what type of jobs are out there. So I actually did that just earlier today, just to give people a feel, some even additional contracts that may be a little bit further out in the future, call it the fall, maybe winter time. We have some noise wall repair and replacement coming up, some additional landscaping, some additional way in motion. I talked about the one on 355, but there's some other way in motion work. So you may want to be, if you're interested in 355, there may be more way in motion work in your future, as well as we have some toll plaza modifications and some possible truck parking. So the majority of our contracts, I told you, Tollway is completely committed to unbundling and putting small business contracts out there. The majority of the contracts that we've already awarded in 2021 have been small business and have been ROSIP contracts. We're always looking for more opportunities. And, if you can check our website on a regular basis, we're always trying to unbundle work and add jobs to our bid letting schedule for exactly the reason giving people that opportunity, especially contractors that haven't worked for the tollway. And there's some intimidation about, taking that leap to work for this, for our agency. We feel the small business initiative program, including our ROSIP, which is part of that small bundling initiative, gives you that great opportunity. So if you go up to our website, as you see up here on our screen right now, so if you go under Doing Business, if you click on Doing Business and then you go to Construction and Engineering, okay, and if you go over on the left-hand side, there's a bids and bulletins area. Click one below it, bids and bulletins. You click on that. There you go. And about there's a bid letting schedule for future projects. You see the little pointer right there? That's the page right there. You may want to bookmark and check it every 1 to 2 weeks. So you'll see there's a PDF that we update. We break down this PDF into various different colors, which basically mean the corridor of the type of work you're working on. So, you know, there you'll see on the Elgin O'Hare, I think, is green. Yellow is I-294 work system-wide. That means these are a lot of small jobs on the system-wide are white in color. So it's 3 pages long, but it will give you an idea when that contract is going to be advertised, which basically means contractors are able to then acquire the plans from our online plan room and review the bid. It will show you when the bid opening is, when your notice to proceed is going to start, and when you anticipate construction to be completed. So hopefully this is like called the Rosetta Stone and the first step in finding out about the tollways programs. So now I'd like to turn it back over to Lorena.
Thank you so much, Pete, Paula, Michael, and Siobhan for a great presentation. At this point, if anyone has any questions in the audience, please go ahead and enter them into the chat box or the question and answer section. I will put the link to the bid letting schedule in the chat box for anyone that wants to take a look at it or hasn't been able to locate that on the website. Also, keep in mind that the webinar is being recorded and the presentation will be posted to the website for reference in the future. So if nobody knows where that is, that's on the webinar series page and the same web page we were just on. So what I'll do is I will also link it in the chat for all the attendees that are interested. So I do see a couple of questions come in already. Is there any cost associated with being a part of the ROSET? If there are no claims on the job, also, are only diverse firms allowed to participate?
Okay, so there are no premiums associated. The premiums are borne by the tollway. So as long as you have no claims, there should be no cost to have the insurance provided to you. As far as diverse firms, I believe it's the SBI program. It's based on small firms, right? And Siobhan or somebody in diversity could probably answer this way better than me. The state dictates what's considered a small firm and that's who can participate, correct?
I can answer that for you. The program itself is race and gender neutral. It's about the small size of the firm. So it's predicated by gross revenue and not predicated on being race or gender specific.
Thank you.
Thank you, guys. More questions here. Do contractors have to subcontract their insurance costs from bids for ROSIP approved projects?
Yes, you should be subtracting that.
Okay, is there anybody, just a reminder, anyone in the audience, if you have any questions, please go ahead and enter it into the chat box or the question and answer section. One of the slides said that this was mandatory. What if you're not an SBI contractor?
So enrollment into the ROSIP is mandatory, but again, diversity, Terry, I don't know if you can, there are other projects, I believe, that are ROSIP eligible, but I think all the ones under the SBI program, you need to be registered in the SBI program, correct, Harry?
Correct. Correct. You have to be registered in the program, which allows us to verify that you are indeed a small business within the state of Illinois. So that kind of verification is utterly essential in order to participate in the program. And I should also point out that applying for the program is a very straightforward process. So it's fairly quick, it's painless, and I'd encourage you all, if you meet the statutory requirement, if you register with the state, there's no reason why you should not be registered with us. And it's one of those things where I get the registration in advance. That way you see a job that you're interested in, it's one of those things that you don't have to worry about. Hope that answers your question.
Thank you. Where can I find information about the ROSIP in the contract documents?
So it's contained within the special provisions, and then there's also a ROSIP manual, which I believe is out in the plan room, correct, Pete? Both documents are out in the plan room.
Yes, you're exactly right. The ROSIP, it is a section of our specifications. And so you can refer to that in the contract as well as the manuals up on our website. I believe it's under the diversity department, as well as we actually have a second copy within our online plan room that you'd be able to download. So there's two spots, exact same manual that you should be able to find it.
Thank you, guys. Can you touch a little bit more on the coverages? What is included in the ROSIP?
The ROSIP is general liability coverage only for on-site operations. So any other coverages that are required based on the special provisions of the contract would still be the responsibility of the contractor and the sub. So this is for general liability only for on-site operations.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. Can I bid the contract using my insurance program and not the ROSIP?
No, enrollment in the ROSIP is mandatory.
Thank you. Okay, looks like I have a couple more questions here. What happens if I'm the lowest bidder and I'm not accepted into the ROSIP?
So if you are the low bidder, enrollment in the ROSIP is automatic. So you cannot be the low bidder and be rejected. So you have to be a small business, right? Be in the SBI program. But if you're the low bidder, enrollment in the ROSIP is automatic.
Okay, and I have a follow-up question to that. What if it's an unbundled smaller size job that has a ROSIP requirement, but the general contractor doesn't qualify?
Again, enrollment in the ROSIP is automatic if you're the low bidder. So the prime in any subs, as long as they get enrolled, it's an automatic enrollment. So that I don't think that could happen.
Okay, thank you. If the ROSIP is providing general liability insurance coverage, why is my company also required to provide proof of insurance?
So the ROSIP provides general liability for on-site operations only. So we do not cover off-site operations. Obviously, that would be very hard to insure because we don't know what you're doing off-site, right? So the reason we ask is, you know, like I said, workers' comp is still required. This ROSIP is only covering your general liability for on-site. So we need to make sure you have all the other coverages that are required under the construction contract. So that's why we ask you to provide general liability so that it shows you have off-site general liability, workers' comp for on-site and off-site and so forth. Whatever the requirements are under the construction contract, that's why we ask you to submit proof of those other coverages.
Thank you, Paula.
And Paula, can I add, Lorraine, I'm sorry, just a couple of quick. The benefit of having project specific insurance is you still are required as a business to carry the necessary insurance limits to cover your business. One of the hurdles, as Paula mentioned, is the insurance limits for the Illinois Tollway. What this does is it puts you in compliance with the insurance limits for what the tollway has to do for this given project versus you having to have those higher limits for all of your operations. So the benefit is that you have you're in compliance because the hurdles are the contract size and also the insurance. Illinois Tollway has taken away those hurdles. You still have the obligation as a business owner to carry the proper insurance when you're not working with the tollway.
Thank you, Michael.
Thank you, Michael. You put it perfectly.
So one more question, which I think is an easy one. And after that, we're going to go ahead and close it off. Are all insurance requirements outlined in the special provision section of the contract documents?
Absolutely.
All right, with that said, that's all of the questions we have today. Thank you to the presenters today for coming on and sharing all of this information. I'll go ahead and give it to Siobhan to close off. And go ahead, Siobhan.
Thank you, Lorena, for the most up-to-date information on upcoming contracting opportunities. Please visit the tollway website at illinoistollway.com, the ultimate resource for doing business with the tollway. Under the Doing Business tab, you'll find information on diversity program and outreach, construction bid letting schedule, professional service bulletin look ahead schedule, information on the Tollways buying plan, information on getting certified or pre-qualified, resources including our online plan room and videos on submitting bids on tollway work, and how to sign up to receive emails from CMS when new procurement opportunities are available. I want to thank all the presenters. I want to thank all the attendees, and please join us next week, Monday at 3 o'clock. And I just want to tell everyone to have a good day. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Take care.